Dear students, hello and welcome to today's session where we are going to be discussing about interview preparation. In the last session we did talk about various types of interviews that are there, and for each interview type it's essential for us to make sure that we are preparing ourselves in the best possible manner. So let's look at what are the essential elements of job preparation. When we have to talk about the preparation, we do this kind of a preparation at three levels: the physical preparation, mental preparation and the psychological preparation. Let's look at the first perspective. When I talk about physical preparation, very significant sections of this include grooming. When we talk about grooming in particular, we refer to how do you appear. It's your physical appearance primarily which matters a lot. You should be dressed properly. You should have your nail and cut properly cut nails. You shall be able to make your hair in a proper way, and this your choice of clothes for the interview session should be very formal. And all these points will actually affect the first impression that will be there on the interview, right? So when we talk about posture, that is the next important point here. I know that it is not possible in one day to correct your posture. So what is it that we have to make sure? We have to assure that your non-verbal communication should be at its best. And when we refer to non-verbal communication, it is also reflected in the way you are walking into the room, you are leaving the room, while you are sitting in the room. Are you sitting with the correct posture on the chair that has been given to you? All these pointers will affect the way the people on the other side of the table are going to assess your body language. So make sure you present the best of the body postures there. The next point is good manners and conduct. You know, the first important thing that you do when you enter the interview room is the way you greet them. Greet them with a smile. Say whatever your culture talks about in terms of saying namaste, if in case it's a Western culture, shake hands with them. Do not sit until you are asked to sit, or if you have to take permission, please request them by using may I sit, right? Make sure you're not pulling the chair which is there to be sitting in, you are not making any noise, you are not dragging the chair, and while you are leaving the room as well, you must make sure that you are smiling and giving them good wishes for the rest of the day, right? All these actually refer to good manners and conduct. That is also very significantly talking about your personality. Let's look at what kind of preparation do we require when we refer to mental preparation. Your knowledge is something that is very important, but while you have been gaining knowledge for all these years, it's important that you go through the significant information that you have mentioned in your resume or CV, that you are updating your information, that you have the current knowledge in the field of the study or in the area of your expertise. You must also be well informed. You know, when many a time when you go in for the interview, you are asked questions which are related to general knowledge or current affairs. Make sure you have read enough of it to be able to showcase your personal opinion on any of those topics, because interviewers are there to be able to access not only your personality, not only your knowledge about the subject, but also the way in which your opinions have been formed. To what culture do you belong? To what kind of intelligentsia have you developed? The next point is research. Whenever we are going in for an interview, it's essential that we collect all the information about the company. We know well about who are the directors of the company, who are the people who have been working there for the longest time, what kind of turnover the company has had, some information about the benefits that the company has been giving to the employees. Why is it that you are interested in working only in this company? Okay, what could be the possible avenues or the better opportunities that you are looking forward to by joining the company? So this kind of a research shows that you are very much interested in the firm and you are looking forward to joining and working for a learning experience there. The next point is preparation. We all know that there are certain kinds of interviews, interview questions that will surely be asked to you. So for that, it's best that you prepare yourself by attending more and more of mock interviews. There are various sessions there are certain list of questions that you could prepare yourself for with regard to the personal information sharing, with regard to salary negotiations, and certain such things that you know are obvious questions that the interviewer is going to ask you. Let's look at psychological preparation. We know about it that most of us, when we are nervous, our psychological health is impacted, and it shows in our body language as well. So what are the essential elements that we must make sure that these are do's and those are don'ts? So when we talk about the first point, it's honesty. Many a times when we are asked questions, make sure you, if you know the answer, you are able to present it rightly. Whatever up to your best of your knowledge you know, please make sure if you are aware of it, any the question that has been asked, you answer it. But if you do not know the question, it's not expected that you are somebody who know it all, right? So you can politely put forth your point that you are extremely sorry, or you are afraid that you are not aware of the certain things that have happened, or the question that has been asked, you are unable to answer it, right? The next point is inability to discuss a particular topic. When you are asked about your opinion, and there are certain uncomfortable topics for us, or maybe that we are not much aware about, we have not read much, it's best that you prepare yourself by discussing and practicing with your friends in your group, that you gain knowledge and have enough exchange of information in order to be able to prepare yourself to handle the inability to discuss a particular topic. Right? Then the next point is salary negotiation. While you are negotiate your salary, make sure you are not sounding too offensive to the individual. While you are aiming not to be feeling defeated, you are to put forth your points and your negotiation skills to be used at the best. You should not be sounding rude. You should always be polite and be able to make sure that the interviewer observes your qualities in order to put forth the points which are essential for the negotiation. Now, next point is clarity of purpose and determination. When we mention about clarity and determination, what is it that is required? You know, one must have the complete knowledge about the subject, also your personality and your aim. Why is it that you are particularly coming to this firm? What kind of determination do you have in order to get this job? How hard have you worked towards the preparation? These are the points that are going to be helping you prepare yourself at the psychological level. Next point is self-assessment. See, our friends and family members know where is it that we falter, where is it that we need improvement. So make sure you yourself do the analysis before anybody else does the analysis for you, and you practice and make sure that you are overcoming all those difficult areas where you feel that you lack, whether it could be a verbal communication skill which you might lack, or non-verbal communication skill. Make sure you prepare yourself aptly enough. Right? Now let's also look at the preparation at the interview that you must be able to do. Make sure while you are at the interview, you reach there well before the time that has been given to you. It is always good to reach there 10 minutes before. Then your entry makes a lot of significance, because your entry point is also the first impression that you have. So make sure while you greet them, you are making sure that your appearance, your physical appearance is perfectly apt. You are greeting them politely. You're using the right kind of greeting there. And you're not looking nervous. You should always be smiling. Half your battle is won with that kind of approach towards the room. We know that we are all nervous while we are there for the interview, but assure yourself that you are here when you have confidently prepared yourself, you know it, know your subject matter the best, and you are here to give your best. Then while answering the question, you will often be put into situations and thrown questions at you, which will observe how do you balance yourself emotionally. How do you make sure that you are politely giving answers at the best of the capacity that you have to answer those questions, right? So stay polite. Your body language should be controlled there. Your hand should not be there on the table. Try and make sure that your papers are not all over the table which you have carried with you, right? Then you, it is obviously possible for you to ask questions. I'm sure a lot of us will not know much about the company or will have our own queries, specifically when we want to know about the benefits that the company is going to give to us. While you have to ask questions, usually you will be invited by the interviewers to ask questions. If they do not invite you, you can politely request them, may I ask some questions, and politely request them to briefly tell you about the benefits that you will be getting, what kind of pension related plans do you have, what kind of whether it will require traveling, this kind of job will require traveling, or how many how long the working hours will be. These details will be helpful for you. While leaving, it's significant for us to leave a good impression. While leaving, make sure you put the chair back. You are leaving, be ready that you are ready to shake hands if in case somebody offers you to. Until unless they do not ask you, please make sure you just smile and give them good wishes. Say them, bid them goodbye. Say have a nice day ahead, or some of these positive greetings that could be there while leaving. You could mention those, and make sure you are not fiddling, you are not dragging the chair, and put the chair back in place and leave. Those body postures and the way you walk out of the room with a smile will also help you leave a lasting impression on the interviewers. Now, while the interviewers are going to be looking at your overall personality, how do they make sure that they draw the personality sketch? They draw it by looking at your communication skills. Each one of us has to prepare ourselves in order to be able to communicate our points very clearly. So prepare yourself for that. Your qualification is obviously mentioned by you in the CV, yet how much your qualification has helped you shape up your personality will be observed here. Your natural abilities includes the skills that you have. What kind of skills have you developed over a course of time, duration that you've spent in your school, in your college, during graduation? Those natural abilities to be able to cope with stress situations will also be helpful in the assessment. Stress tolerance and adjustments will obviously be looked at by the interviewers by putting you into situations, by asking you questions about different situations. So, your own personality type will be reflected there. Make sure you are very calm, not nervous, and are able to handle the situation and think calmly, right? When you talk about motivation, how determined are you? Too much motivation or high motivation driven people are also not too good. So, make sure you maintain the right balance. You might be expected to be leading a team. Will you be able to help the other teammates motivated during the task that is given to you? That is also a significant part of the personality sketch. Are you a team player or not? Right? So keep these points in mind. Let's now look at how have we put in use all the points that we have discussed here. I'm looking forward to many of you doing good in the interview that you're going to take, to be able to access and understand how many different types of interviews do we have and what kind of preparation do we require. So all the best for the interviews that you are going to be appearing for. Thank you.